Who are you? What are we doing?
We are filming. That's it. Where were you filming? This is how it is. Welcome. Well, welcome to the line of fire. Listen, I'm a rib boat guy. Okay.
Okay.
I love rib boats.
Okay.
And I just stumbled. Look, I came over here to Solis. I'm filming Solis.
Yeah.
Todd is like, yo, you got to see this amazing rib boat. And I said, you don't have to tell me twice. So I was sitting down. I was having a beer. I stood up and I'm here now. And boom, introduce yourself.
Hey.
What's your name?
I'm Sandy Ballou with Ocean1.
All right, Sandy. So you have just been, this is how my channel is, right?
It's totally like,
we're just running, right. Yeah, totally running good. All right, so there's a good thing about this, right? That I'm professional.
Yeah.
But I'm not. So you don't have to worry.
But you edit out all the
stuff. No, there's no bad stuff. Because we're going to do this one take. Come over here, Sandy. Okay. So listen up.
So you're asking me questions?
We're going to, you know the boat, don't you?
Sure.
All right, so that's what.
But you're asking me questions or am I starting?
No. We're starting from here, right? Okay. So we have a rib boat. What rib boat is this?
This is the Rogue 370.
Okay, guys. So Ocean welcome to Palm Beach Boat Show. And we're on a rib boat. And it's called the Rogue 370. Come, let's go, Sandy. Let's go ahead and take. Let's. Okay, so Ocean One is the manufacturer.
Correct.
Okay, so you want me to take off my shoes real quick? So yeah, I think I should, guys. You sure?
Yep.
All right, guys. So look, first and foremost, I see some carbon fiber hyperlon, probably from Orca, on this rigid inflatable. Is this air or is this foam? What are we? Oh, it's
air.
It's air. I love it. I'm already a fan.
And we got our own compressor and pump system, automatically fills to whatever PSI you set it at.
Nice.
So easy to keep the tubes topped off where they need to be.
So you don't even have to worry about pumping or opening valves or anything. It does it automatically.
No manual pumping or any of that stuff. There are a couple of valves to open, but that's it.
All right. So let's start here in after the boat, and I guess walk and talk me and tell me some of the configurations.
So right, we got the horseshoe seating right here.
Okay.
We got almost unlimited seating options. All our boats are built to order, so they're highly customized. So what you see here is just an example of what one customer wanted, and we can set up the seating in lots of different configurations.
You can put live wells if you want.
We can set it up to.
Oh my! You see.
This one has actually been in service as a yacht tender for over a year.
Okay.
It's got almost 20,000 miles under the bottom already. It's been across the Atlantic, been through the Panama Canal, all through Mag Bay.
So this thing has its...
This thing's already been put through its paces, yeah.
So where are you guys making these hulls?
In Sarasota.
In Sarasota. So Sarasota has a huge, huge marine... You know, a lot of boats are made in that area.
Absolutely.
Guys,
big,
Sarasota, big part of the industry over there. Yep. So tell me a little bit about the helm and here what we got and some of the configuration options we got here, Sandy.
This is our standard Ocean1 helm seating, helm seating. Again, we can do other seating options. We can do shock mitigation seats. We can do release sport fish seats. We can do lots of different things. This has got a Garmin setup, obviously, twin screens. Again, that can all be changed and customized to what the customer's preference is.
I am loving this boat. So
this boat is set up with the teak deck, which again can be changed to sea deck or non-skid or whatever, but there's not much better than real teak.
Is this a removable door that I have here on the floor?
This is the plug from the loading door that we came in back there. So this baby drops right in, and that
boom, just like that, easy.
Fill you back in.
So we got a windlass on this here.
Yep. Of course, we got the anchor locker with a windlass tucked back under there. It'd be a little hard to see.
Can you explain why somebody might want this inflatable as a tender? Now that you have just told them there's about 20,000. Miles on this bad boy. Tell me what, say somebody might want this as a tender or maybe not even a tender, maybe a day boat to go ahead and run across to the Bahamas.
Right. So in the U.S. market, the ribs generally are just getting more accepted as recreational boats, but they've long been used as yacht tenders and other commercial applications.
Absolutely.
Obviously, with a collar, you get a soft ride, you get a dry ride, you get a safe ride, and
yes.
And you got a giant fender all the way around the boat. So
it's
if you roll up on an expensive yacht or another boat.
Yeah. So guys, it's almost having. I always tell people that when they ask me what's a rib boat, and I say, imagine a boat with a life vest on.
Yeah, there you go.
That's what it is.
A boat with a life jacket.
there it is. So it'll float like you can. He can deflate all these tubes completely, and this boat is still going to operate exactly the same. Obviously, it's going to be much better once it's inflated.
Yeah.
You know, because it's going to be softer. It's going to prevent a lot of things.
Another feature or design element to the collar is that there are five compartments on this collar, which means if you do puncture one inadvertently, you're only going to lose a section of the collar. You don't lose the whole collar.
So there's baffles
yep.
in between,
right.
And I'll tell you where there's a baffle right here. No, well, so you'll have. I can't see the marking there, but you'll see where the baffle is, guys.
Yeah, there's one. So I think there's one right here. Another one here, and then the bow is another section.
Now let me tell you, they did a very good job hiding the bow. Look, right here, you see the one here? You see this? Look at this. This is this compartment from here to here. Very subtle.
Yep.
To here. You see that? You see that? So that, for instance, if you lose the bow, everything else is still going to remain inflated, right?
Right.
Say you hit something, you puncture some. So what do we got going on in that console? Do we have something in there?
Yeah, so inside the console, there's a bunch of storage and a head. Pretty typical.
So what year is this boat, Sonny?
This is a 21. You can have a peek in there.
Oh, wow, so you have a lot of space in here.
A lot of headroom, like 6-7, I think, is the headroom.
Yeah, so, I wouldn't have thought that this was so big in here.
Right.
And you have access to your panels back here if you open that up?
Yep.
All your electronics, guys. Look at that. Easily serviceable.
This is going to swing closed from experience.
Yes, absolutely. There we go.
Nice, neat wiring, all labeled up.
Sarasota, guys.
Sarasota.
So many, industry veterans come out of that area. What are we talking about fuel capacity on something like this, Sandy?
Standard fuel tank is about 350. We can add another 100.
450 on this rib boat?
Yep.
What, do you want to go to the Bahamas 10 times and back?
Yeah.
What?
So,
why do you need so much fuel on a rib boat? They're so efficient.
Right. Well, as a yacht tender, they need a lot of fuel capacity because they're not always able to refuel.
Yeah.
They got to cover a lot of distance and get towed around in different locations.
So
constantly.
This is powered with what, 300s?
Yep, these are twin Mercury Verado 300s.
And how fast is this boat going with these 300s?
Top end is right in the mid 50s. And our fuel burn at cruise is about 1.4 miles to the gallon.
Seakeeper option on something like this?
There is a seakeeper.
And is this the beam right here, 10-2?
Yeah, you can see the
max draft
right
2.6, weight 9,000 pounds.
So actually 10.9. This is the 37 right here, the one that we're on.
Mm-hmm.
This is a smaller boat that we build in the same.
And you got a 400 coming?
Yeah, and we got a 40 as well.
Is that a remade or is it coming?
So that's been made under the Yellowfin Custom 40 brand.
Okay.
And we can still make that boat under license with Yellowfin.
Wow, so it's got a Yellowfin bottom.
Yep, got a Yellowfin 39 hull.
Wow.
Exactly right.
Wow.
Seakeeper's in here.
Crazy.
It's hard to see, but you can see the base of it right under there.
Nice. What's a 450s, twin 450s? How's this thing moving with those?
Twin 450s?
Yeah.
Probably running about low 60s, 62, 63.
So we're talking about, we're up there. And this is a big boat.
Yeah. Weighs about 12.5. It's actually light for its size. which is why we're getting good fuel economy with only 600 horsepower on this boat.
Price points on something like this on this 37?
It's right around 550, 600, depending on how many options you lay on.
Anything else that, maybe they can put on there that, we haven't talked about, Sandy?
Well, again, seating, decking, electronics, power, colors, all those are ways to customize the boat to your liking.
How's the Alfred Montaner ambush experience so far?
Awesome.
Wait.
It's my first month.
Welcome to my, welcome.
Internet
sensation, right? So listen, you did great. I see there's another door here. Yeah. Is this another access point?
This is, we call the door to nowhere.
Okay.
But no, not really. This is usually outfitted with a rack for all of your swab and brush holes and cleaning supplies.
Okay.
Here we have put the battery switches and the charging port in here as well.
Nice.
On this particular boat.
All right, so where can they go online if they wanted to get more information on this particular boat?
Ocean1yachts.com.
That's where they can go. Any socials, maybe Instagram or
we're
Facebook?
On Instagram and Facebook as well.
Which is what? Same info?
Ocean1 Yachts with O-N-E instead of the number one on Instagram. And I'm not sure about Facebook.
All right, listen, guys. I am going to have to buy Sandy. I'm going to buy you a drink, dude. You deserve it. You just got thrown into the fire. Alfred Montaner making a scene over here.
Thanks, my man.
Todd! Thank you.
What's going on, brother? How you doing over there?
You made it happen over here.
New internet sensation right here. Chickened out.
Sandy just got thrown into the fire. He didn't know the Alfred Montaner fire.
Oh, he's in it now. Do you know what? He used to look as good as I do.
about 10 minutes ago.
Alfred Montaner, Sandy. Todd from Sodas. Where's Daniel? I got to go. I got to run from Daniel, guys.
Guys, we can't knock him. He's
simple custom. We got to run from Daniel.
Another contract.
There you go. Daniel Sodas, Ocean. Palm Beach Boat Show, guys. You should be here.
Hey, look at this critter.
You want to wait for it? Hold on. Let's give it. Let's give him, guys. Hey.
Comes complete with a gecko.
You?